VIRAJ welcomes you all on the first day of the fifth 2 days VIRAJ lecture series. The topic for today's lecture is Gandhi and conflict resolution. Competition, conflict, and violence are inherent in the state of human nature, and it directly affects communal peace and human growth. Violent means out of violent mind don't end in peaceful results in conflict resolution. It can be counterproductive. Short-lived results are no resolution to any conflict. Gandhi believed in means than ends. He considered violence immoral and the rule of brute. Normally, violence in negative aggressive force is seen in relation to peace, and peace in relation to violence. The non-violence in Gandhi's mean and end philosophy offers a transformative force without aggression in dealing with conflict that result to injustices and exploitation. He used his logical and emotive communicating skills through written and spoken words and passive resistance to change the hearts of the violent in conflict resolution. He did not consider non-violent conflict resolution as unpractical utopia. The hesitation to make a beginning is the main obstacle to it. Nevertheless, violence as a means can be legitimate in case of extreme, immoral, mindless, purposeless violence against the innocents, especially when there's choice between cowardice and violence to establish social balance. Gandhi relentlessly fought with non-violent means of equality and communal harmony. His methods were innovative and non-violent, like walks, the Dandi March for injustices, and fast against rioting or separate electorate for Dalits. Both were not political acts, but social extension to his experiments with truth yielding desired results. Non-violence, he believed, is not a personal virtue, but also a social virtue. And if genuinely used, can effectively work against the brute force. Any forced compromise leaves an element of violence which can rebound later, he believed. Is Gandhi relevant in the present day rising intolerance and conflict, religious or between social groups and with the state? Can Gandhi and Swaraj, that is self-realization, self-restraint, and the use of righteous means while expressing the reasons causing violence, be applicable in conflict resolution? Can his wisdom of governing ideas be inspiring and guiding in the contemporary times for peaceful conflict resolution? To discuss all this, we have Professor Ashok Vohra. Professor Ashok Vohra has taught at St. Stephen's College. He is professor and head of the Department of Philosophy and Dean Arts Faculty of University of Delhi. He was director of Gandhi Bhavan, the Center for Gandhian Studies, University of Delhi, vice president of UNESCO's Asia-Pacific Philosophy Education for Democracy, and member of Indian Council of Philosophical Research. He has extensively published papers and articles and is on editorial board of National and International Journal of Philosophy. He has authored Wittgenstein's Philosophy of Mind, Men, Morals, and Self, co-authored Radhakrishnan, His Life and Ideas, and co-edited The Philosophy of K. Satchidanandan Murthy and Dharma, the Categorical Imperative. Most importantly, he translated Ludwig Wittgenstein's Philosophical Investigations in Hindi, beside others, for which he received the most prestigious philosophy award. He has widely been delivering lectures in India and abroad, and writes for national dailies, mostly on philosophical themes, including in speaking Greek column Times of India. He is currently working on Hinduism, humanism, and human rights.
Thank you. Friends, at the beginning, I must thank VIRAJ Foundation, especially Professor Saxena, who has given me this opportunity to talk to you. Of course, we started in time, but there were a lot of problems in coming to this space. This also shows how Gandhi was relevant in talking about village industries, small-scale industries, and all that, and not having all these big cars and things like that. Today, Dr. Saxena started with the question, is Gandhi relevant? Is Gandhi relevant to solve the philosophy, the religious conflicts or conflicts that we face in our society, in ourselves? I don't think there is a question of can Gandhi is relevant. Gandhi's methods are as relevant today as they were earlier. So Gandhi, this question, is he relevant? This question is not really relevant at all, because Gandhi is, was, and will be relevant for all times to come. Today, I'm going to talk about religious conflict resolution, inefficacy of Gandhian methods. The two key terms in religious conflict is religion and conflict.